One UI 6, or Samsung's version of Android 14, is coming very soon to all kinds of Galaxy devices, and I have the latest beta here on my 2022 Galaxy S22. Even though this phone is reaching almost 2 years now, older Galaxy devices like this are still getting a ton of new features and changes. Unlike the last few One UI updates, there are some major visual and under the hood changes here, so you'll want to watch the rest of this video to see what some of the biggest ones are coming to your Samsung phone. And once I have the final release here, I'll be daily driving this phone again for an almost 2 year revisited video. If you're interested in that video, make sure to subscribe to the channel and stay tuned. Okay, let's get started with the biggest visual change, which is the quick settings or the quick panel. It's got an all new layout, so you get more options on one screen. Wi-Fi and Bluetooth have a permanent spot here, as well as controls for eye comfort shield and dark mode. Of course, this middle icon area is customizable as always, and just like iOS, you have the option to quickly access this by swiping down on the right side of the status bar. The left side is still reserved for the notifications, which also has some updates. One UI and Android already had a really great notification system, but some apps, especially messaging apps, sort of botch them when you receive multiple messages from different people. Now, One UI separates them as individual cards, so it's really easy to do quick replies and to save some notifications for another time. The new media controller or player card also looks a lot nicer. Like how Pixel UI has been doing it, the album art now covers the entire card. Not a huge thing, but it just looks a lot nicer. A little less visual, but still important, is all the improvements coming to the camera and gallery apps. There is now a level line if you have grid lines turned on, which is sort of essential for me when framing my photos, so I'm very happy that's here. Changing photo resolution is now so much quicker. It's just a tap at this button at the top, and you can switch between 12 and 50 megapixels. Same thing on the video side, it's a lot faster to change the video quality now. The document scanning feature is also its own thing now, so you can just go straight to scanning the document you want and edit right away. If you go a little deeper into the camera settings, you now have the option to speed up your post-processing times. The final result is still the most important to me, so I keep it at maximum, but if you hate how long it takes for your phone to post-process a photo, then you can go for medium or even minimum instead. There's also a new auto FPS feature for video recording. You can get brighter video results in low light by having the camera automatically lower the FPS during a recording. I don't think I'll be using it too much, as I like my videos to be at a consistent frame rate, but it's a neat feature to have. We also have some changes in the gallery. When you select a subject or object from a photo, you can quickly save it as a sticker and use it for all your messaging apps, which can be pretty funny. The editing menu is also a lot more accessible. You can find the editing tools easier and it's just more seamless to use. The studio video editor is also more complex now. It's basically like CapCut at this point, with project-based editing and timelines with multiple clips and layers. It's not as feature-rich as CapCut or any of those video editing options, but it's nice to have a native editor like this get better. Next up is a weather app, which looks much nicer. You get much more information in a single view, and even access to info like snowfall, moon phases, atmospheric pressure, and all that straight from the app. The animations and the colors change depending on the weather. There's also a map that you can swipe around and see the weather conditions as you tap the locations. Really cool stuff, and I think it'll be helpful for traveling. There's also a new widget that gives you extra insights without you having to open the app. Bonus thing, while we're here on the home screen, you can now drag and drop apps and widgets with two hands. Makes it so much faster for organizing your home screen. Just like that, there's some nice changes for the more power users. Pop-up windows now stay open when you open the recent apps menu, which is a great choice. And then in modes and routines, each mode can have its own unique lock screen. So if you want a more distraction-free lock screen for when you're driving or working, you can now do that. There's also a lot of new conditions and actions. So if you're into automation, shortcuts, and really customizing your experience, definitely take a look through these. Last but not least is all the new little changes that you might miss, but I really like them. You may have noticed already, but One UI has a new default font. It's not a setting you have to change. As soon as you have the update, you'll have it here. A lot of techies think One UI is ugly, so I think this font addresses that a little bit. Looks a lot more modern, that's for sure. The battery page and the settings is now separate from the device care page. One UI combined them a while back, which made it a little inconvenient to check the battery settings, but now we don't have that problem anymore. There's also more info than the typical stock Android settings, so that's nice too. Smart Select also got some improvements, where you can now resize and select text from pin selections. If your selection needs more precision, a magnified view appears when you tap and hold. Besides those things, there's some new lock screen clock fonts and styles, and a lot more under the hood. One UI 6 really packs a lot, and I'm really excited to test it out as my daily driver. Honestly, I get more excited about One UI updates than Android OS updates, because there are so many advanced features if you dig in. Like I said, I'm going to be doing a 2 year check-in on this phone, so make sure to subscribe to the channel and stay tuned for that video. Let me know in the comments what feature you're most excited for and what your overall thoughts are on One UI 6. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys on the next video.